Welcome, everyone, to the Real Whovians Cast, episode 853. I am your host, Matrix Lord 212, and I'm with James. What's up, James?
Hey, guys.
All right, so we got some news. What do we have, sir?
We have two sets of news. Where should we start? Should we start with the Power of the Daleks?
Abso-freaking-lutely.
Okay, so the Power of the Daleks is to be shown in U.S. cinemas, apparently. Well, it's not apparently, it's actual news. It will be shown on the 14th of November, a few days before it premieres on television.
That's sick.
November.
That is fantastic. Unbelievable, because this is a thing that's doing really well now, that they're just putting stuff in the theaters besides the movies to generate some money and stuff. And Doctor Who made a couple million here or there when they did that stuff before. So
yeah, that's right.
Who gets that money, though?
Well, they don't usually do it for classic episodes, do they? I mean, it's unusual, so they really are poshing this.
But who gets the money? What do they do with the money? If it's in America, does it stay with BBC America?
Well, it depends who they're selling. I mean, they have to sell it to whoever is showing it, right?
Right, so, distributor, right?
Yeah, I wouldn't know what the percentage of it. That's why you need some clever clogs to know what the percentage of that would be. But
because I know, just not to take away from Doctor Who, but Shin Gojira, which is New Godzilla, I guess, translation, or Godzilla Resurgence, that's been limited release this week, and it's been making like 300,000 a day.
Yeah.
So, I mean, and that's only for a week's worth of release. Every day it's like 300,000. Probably the weekend it's going to do phenomenal. For an episode like Power of the Daleks, to generate like more money than the Doctor Who movies or whatever. I mean, that'd be phenomenal if it made millions.
It would be great. Now, the fact that they're doing this means they're very confident in it, which is a good sign.
Right.
And it suggests to me that maybe they're entertaining the fact of doing more animations if this company is willing, which is a very good sign. Because, you know, it's different.
I honestly think, like, these movie theaters, right? Most of the time, the movie starts at 12 o'clock in the afternoon, right? And then the matinees end at 6 o'clock, right? I honestly think that these movie theaters need to have stuff at, like, 10 in the morning. Maybe they could do, like, TV shows, like Doctor Who or something every Saturday or Sunday. And they could make a lot of money. I mean, that's the whole thing with the economy the way it is and stuff. Thank you, sweetheart. But with the economy the way it is, got my Doctor Who mug. It needs to generate more money, and I think that they should take the money and do more of these animation things, like the money that makes from the Power of the Daleks in the theaters. They should do more of these reimaginations.
They've done this to suggest. So what all they'll do is, if it does fantastically well, then of course they'll most likely invest in, you know, other animation projects. But
I'm just trying to see if it appears while you're talking.
Yeah.
Because it's dematerializing, I think, there. And it should be appearing there. Good, I'm sorry, I'm on the track away.
It's a very good mug, though. I like that mug. I bet that costs some bucks, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
So it's quite exciting. I hope it does well. I really hope it does well. They need to market it, though, because it's an animated lost story. And, you know, Doctor Who, even though it's got quite big in the US, Classic Who is not up there.
Yeah.
Animate it really well.
I used to get beat up for it, to tell you the truth. So.
Yeah, I remember those days. I still remember them.
Moffat said he got beat up. So.
When I go on Xbox, for example, a lot of people will recognize my, you know, account, which has Dalek, and they're like, oh, Doctor Who, and they're all American. So, what else? Do you want to go on the next story? Or?
Well, I just want to talk about one thing.
Yeah.
Like, maybe about 10 years ago, right? I used to constantly go into, like, Barnes & Noble or a bookstore, and I'm like, you have the Doctor Who calendar, and they're like, Doctor what? You know, now they have stuff all over the place in the bookstores. They have toys. They have calendars. It's a wonderful thing that ever since they started advertising like from Russell T. Davis to Moffat. Moffat was very famous for spending money in the U.S. on buses and everything.
Yes,
Russell T. Davis a little bit, but I think Moffat more so, because Russell T. Davis used to block all videos where you couldn't watch the episodes or try to. Moffat was like more lenient, you know?
Now, I will say, even though Moffat did a fairly good job advertising the U.S., the biggest credit has to go to Netflix. Netflix sold Doctor Who.
God, I love that. The only thing I wish about Netflix is, I wish they wouldn't be so, you know, like only one or two episodes, two or three episodes for the Doctor, per Doctor. I would love to have a whole season to show the whole run for Tom Baker or something.
Yeah, the classic series, yeah. They do that, and that's due to just them selling. I think it's a deal they have with BBC Worldwide, and I don't think they're just allowed to put it all on there. Because
sometimes people are lazy, you know?
Yeah.
For me to actually, you know, it's like I could go over there, I could pull out five Doctors, I could go all in the living room, I could put it in the DVD player, right? Or the VHS, right? They don't want that. Yeah. They're like, quick, beep, 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 beep. Oh, it's not there. What's happening? You know?
The reason why they're doing that is because they've got BBC Store now.
Right.
And they're really trying to push that, where they sell all the BBC stuff. I mean, I'm actually surprised the new show is on Netflix, but I think they'll keep it there because the American audience has grown so vastly because it's been on Netflix. But BBC Store's on. If the BBC just said, yeah, have all the classic episodes for One Doctor there, they'd lose money. So it's not good for them. That's why they're not doing it. It's just a business decision, really. It's a shame, really, because I'd love it to be on there, because if they took the chance and put it on there, you get the new generation into the classic.
Oh, yeah, definitely. All right, October is Patrick Troughton month.
Yeah.
I mean, I go wild. It'd be crazy. People will go nuts, I think.
I think Netflix should really try and push them for that. What will happen is, if people will be into the show, they want to know more, and they're like, oh, I want to see this Doctor now. Well, I'll go on BBC Store and buy that season now. See?
I really think what they should do is, not that they should Americanize it, but America's famous for, like, marketing this stuff, right? They really need to do, and it wouldn't interfere with Capaldi. Why can't they do an animated series every Saturday morning? Right? A run of like 24 episodes. And why can't they do an animated with Matt Smith, with David Tennant, actual voice of the characters and everything?
Well, we have Tom Baker in Star Wars Rebels. Not animated himself.
I know, but we did have David Tennant with Freeman Agyeman in that Infinity Quest thing or whatever it was, the animated couple episodes. Remember that?
Yeah, I remember that. I think that was a good... I liked that, actually.
Why can't they just do that, though?
I think, first of all, money. It does cost... Animations do cost money. But mainly, I think it's because they fear it would be better than the current show, and it would cannibalize that.
I don't think they should worry about that at all.
Because what they should do is make it maybe not 24 straight away. You know, trial it. 6 episodes, right? You do trials with these sort of things. Trial it 6, 12 episodes, see what it's like. Put it in a part of the year where we don't have Doctor Who, like Fear the Walking Dead and Walking Dead does. Mm. Whatever your criticism against Fear the Walking Dead is, it's better having Fear the Walking Dead than nothing at all.
Right. You know what I would do? If I was showrunner Doctor Who, right? I would take the Christmas special as an opportunity where the main actor, that's a Doctor, doesn't have to appear because it's a special, right? So I would totally use that to my advantage. And I would, like, have a lost episode with McCann or, like, somebody, you know? And people would lose their mind. They would lose their mind.
If they were going to do it, you have to do McCann. David Tennant chose to leave. Matt Smith chose to leave. And they had a great run. McCann didn't choose to leave. He's never had that chance. And he is so brilliant. He deserves a chance above the others, I would say.
If I was a billionaire, right, I would go to BBC and I'd be like, listen, give him millions. I'm paying for it myself. You do everything. But I want, like, a couple of seasons of McCann so I could see I could have something with that Doctor, you know?
I think they're very foolish, because I think what they should do if they should pull Sherlock, really. Even let Moffat stay with McGann. Have him have his little
special series,
right? A special series where you trial it with 3 episodes, but you're a bit longer, right? With McGann. So 3 specials with McGann, apart the other Doctor Who it's not on, and see how it goes. And if it's great, keep it going. And right. Have your own Doctor Who. That's the thing with Doctor Who. It's such a big universe. And the BBC run it so poorly. They don't understand the opportunity they have.
They don't know how to market anything. I mean, do you realize that we got screwed over with the 50th anniversary, that they had to split Series 7 into the other year, which is the Doctor Who anniversary year? And then we got the 50th, which all they had to do, they could have gave us 2 damn seasons. But they got to, like, every time, it's like, how is it that, you know, we're missing seasons? Yeah. I mean, even the Top Gear thing, because the ego and because the stupid thing, they fired, they lost those guys. Those guys are going to make quadruple what they were making now.
Oh, yeah.
and the Bake Off, too, they lost that, too. Right?
Yeah. They're very foolish.
Everybody.
It's because they get a license fee. See, the way the license fee works is it's a tax in the UK. Well, the United Kingdom, so all the IOs have to pay it, where anyone who watches or records live TV has to pay a tax. Now, even if you don't watch the BBC, it goes to the BBC. That's, first of all, it's the most ridiculous tax ever. Because they have so much money, because they have a guaranteed income, there's quite a lot of arrogance there.
So why don't they spend money on these shows? Why don't they just like start doing spin-offs?
Foolishly. For example, we have a thing called Match of the Day, where I can't remember the footballer's name. I should know his name. It's Gary something, I think. But he's a famous footballer, right, in the UK. And he makes millions and millions and millions in the, you know, throughout the year. And he's just sitting there talking. And it's such a waste of money. They waste so much money. Wow. Nobody's interested in. But, you know, they have an opportunity. I mean, it's a shame just because...
you know what? Not for nothing. Take a risk.
Yeah, look at Marvel.
Paul McGann. I don't think you would complain, James.
Yeah, I wouldn't. Nobody would complain. Look at Marvel, Daredevil, Jessica Jones, right?
They are throwing stuff out there that shouldn't even have series because they're like, oh, it will work. Cloak and Dagger, boom. They're throwing everything out there, man. It's like nothing's failing right now. Nothing.
So good for them as well.
They made a funny skit on Saturday Night Live years ago about that with Marvel. They said Marvel could make a movie called Shopping Carts the Movie. And it would be like the number one movie because they just know what they're doing, you know?
I wouldn't say I want AMC to have Doctor Who, but I would like some of the smart business decisions from some corporates because the BBC are not very smart. They just sack a lot of shows and don't expand the good shows.
Right. See, me, I like when the doctor, when everything gets answered, you know, and it's like a clean end. Like with David Tennant, I'm like, okay, you know, end of time, I like that, you know. Matt Smith, not at all. What's that?
Then the Daleks, that was the only criticism I ever had of David Tennant's seasons was the Daleks was always the bad guy. Do you know what the end of the season, apart from the Master season, that's... I loved his second season with Freeman. I thought that was it's very underrated, and the way they built.
In the third season? His season with Mother.
Yeah, I thought that was a great season. I love Donna, and you know Donna's great.
Yeah.
But Martha was just poorly written, but the actress was very good.
Yeah, she's doing her show on Netflix now.
Season 2. It's awesome.
Yeah.
So before we get off too much off topic, we do have another.
Didn't they used to have Doctor Who shows showing the episodes, like a kids show? Like, I mean, they lost everything, didn't they?
Oh yeah, they've. Because
there's no Doctor Who to show, so
there's no behind the scenes. There's a little like
YouTube. There's no confidential, nothing.
Yeah, it's just a YouTube video. No, that's what it is. It's just crap. It's a shame. I really do feel like if they carry on at this rate, there'll be no Doctor Who because of just the complete incompetency.
Yeah.
You know, you can't have a show that's successful and if you keep taking ridiculously long breaks like they do.
Yeah. Hopefully. All right, we're going to come back and do another Real Whoopians. I'm going to take a five-minute break. James, it's been awesome. And when we come back, we're going to talk about some Series 10 stuff. So take care. Bye for now.